Hi, this is Kelly from The Truth and Story, and I'm here to show you something interesting that I found. I don't know how this is going to work out, but we're going to look at this together. But before I do that, let me just show you something real quick. I had bemoaned the fact that when I decided to get Katie the Shadowscapes, I bought her the Shadowscape box set, and I was going to give her that for Easter for Easter present, because she wanted to get into tarot more. We decided that would be the big, with all your guys' help and thinking things through, we decided that was going to be the best one for her. Well, I decided, Katie is one of these people that really likes things that are inherited. She likes the energy of things being passed down. So I decided that I would give her mine, or I asked her. I gave her the box so she could open it up and everything, and then I told her if she wanted my Shadowscape, which I spent a lot of time with, she could have that, and then I would keep the new one, and you know, what we just swapped the new one. She went for that right away, because again, she likes that kind of thing. So she took the book and everything, and she just left me the cards, the new cards. Lo and behold, they were the new cards that were the thicker deck. They were not my beloved Shadowscape cards. I was so disappointed. And then I can't remember her name now on YouTube. It's usually the other way around, and I don't want to say her personal name. I don't want to say her name. Somebody said, I have it. I have the Shadowscapes, and I don't like it because it's too thin, so do you want to swap? And I said, yes. So she hasn't been using it. She's been sitting there because she doesn't like the cardstock. I said, please, yes. So we swapped, and she sent me hers, and I sent her the new one. And within it, she made this wonderful medicine bag full of like herbs and smells amazing. Oh, so amazing. And inside it was a piece of lepidolite, which, if you know, if you follow my channel, I used this the week of Michael's birthday in this little worry stone, and I knew right away it was something that I was going to want more of. And so she sent me this. This size to me is just fantastic, because it's like, they're like palm stones, I think they call them, and I love it. And so she sent me this, and it feels amazing. And now I have two. I like having two of things. So wonderful. And then this is a piece of rainbow moonstone. It's black and white. Look at, I have a piece about the size of sunstone, and I thought that would be amazing to have, you know, kind of a sun and moon stone, a little sun and moon stone. Love that idea so very much. So I'm going to put that with that. And then this, though, for me is kind of the star. This is a Botswana agate, or like a gray striped egg, I don't know, but I saw Botswana, I looked it up, and this has the most amazing energy to me. It really has a fantastic energy to this piece here. So she sent me that along with the Shadowscape deck that we swapped. All of these were down in the herbs and everything like that, and it's just amazing. Wait, I put my other one, this one with the moonstone. Anyways, you get the idea. That was so sweet. So thank you so much. I got that from her a little while ago, but I wanted to make sure I had the stones out because I wanted to show them to you. Oh, I need to do a stone update so you can see which I've been working with. But what we're here for is this particular. My niece uses the story cards. We talked about the story cards a while ago, and my niece uses them every week. She draws three cards, and then she writes a story, and she brings it back to me the next week, and we edit it. Those story cards are amazing. Now, people use them for oracle cards. I don't draw them out too much for oracle cards because she's always working with them, but they work beautifully as oracle cards. But she wanted another one, and so we ordered her the haunted house set because she wanted to tell a scary story. So what was interesting is while I was looking for those to get for her, I stumbled on this because I figured this would be good for her even if it doesn't work as kind of an oracle-y current kind of thing. But it's called Once Upon a Time, the Storytelling Card Game. It has 110 cards of the Once Upon a Time cards. It has 55 Happily Ever After cards. And then it has 5 blank cards that you could make into whatever you want. So, just a minute. It's back. She's been very good today and very patient. So I need to give her a chew thing. I have a pack. I actually have a pack of chew things at my table, just in case I need them. So what these are, this is obviously made to be a playing game, but I really think these would make a wonderful oracle. So it comes in this little slide box. These are like split into three. You know, you have one pile of the Happily Ever Afters, which have a different backing. So here's the backing for the Happily Ever Afters. They're not all Happily Ever Afters. And then all the other cards have this backing. But it's basically a way of telling story and like round robin. So you would go back and forth. You can interrupt each other's stories. And everybody is given a Happily Ever After card at the end to wind up their story. So that's why there's two piles. So we'll get to that in a minute. This is obviously, I'm just going to looking at this in terms of a how you might read this as an oracle. So the cards that we have, I've shown you there are four blank ones. Then there are character cards, which are characters. So we have the old man, a bird, a fairy, a princess, a witch, a thief, a stepmother, a giant, an old woman, a wolf, a child, parents, king, beggars, enemy, a death, which shouldn't, that's in the wrong category. Oops, I got a couple at the end that go in the other one, so that's a different one. And then there are interrupts where something changes the game and all of a sudden we have interrupting the character. We have husband and wife. You can read it as a monster, somebody becomes orphan, something about a horse or a frog. So these are interrupts. I'm not sure that I would use these, although they may work out, but I'm going to try them separately first. So these are characters, and you can see there's a little insignia, and it says character, and it has a little icon, and these are brother and sister. Then this one are aspects. So this is aspects: wise, frightened, disguised, tiny, poison, far away, ugly, animal can talk, stolen, beautiful, sleeping, and so on and so forth. And then we have some interrupts for aspects. So something goes insane, the item can talk, somebody becomes blind, stupid, or evil. So that's, again, interrupts. I'm not sure if I'm going to use those, so I'm just setting them aside for now. These are events. So an escape, a death, something is revealed, an argument, journey, fight, chase, transformation, and then we have interrupts of events. So there's a storm, there's a plan, there's a contest, there's a dream. I'm not going to obviously go through all these because there's a ton of cards. So then we have items, and these are interrupts. So a key to open something, a gift, a tree. So treasure, spell, ring, gown, book, boat, door, axe, fire. So those are items. And then lastly, we have places, and there are interrupts for the place, stairs taking you somewhere else, going home, chapel, and a kitchen. So these, again, are the interrupt piles. I'm going to try one with that and one without. So then we have, so these are places: village, prison, ruin, nighttime, tower, kingdom, island, cottage, town, road. Now, my thinking is, you know, I might go through these and, you know, kind of filter out some that just aren't really going to make any sense in doing an oracle. But before I did that, you know, I wanted to give it a go. They shuffle quite well. It's quite a thin card stock, and it almost needs to be because you have so many of them that it would be difficult to shuffle otherwise. Now, I think you'd need a nice amount of cards in order to, we're going to just play around with this. Truthfully, I have no clue what's going to happen with this. We're going to just give it a go. And then these I would save because these are outcomes. So here we have cards, and they were blind for the rest of the days for their wickedness and falsehood. They promised never to fight again. For all I know, they may be dancing still. You freed me from enchantment, which proves that A pure heart will always triumph in the end. He saw the error of his ways and repented. So these are all ways in which old story true love had broken the enchantment, how kind of stories end. And so the prophecy had been fulfilled, and so she was reunited with her family. But see, you could still use those, because even though they may not specifically, so everything restored to its former glory, okay, well, you just think about, what does that mean? What kind of ending is that? You know, that is a restoration ending where things were difficult, but then they were restored. So I don't know, I'm going to give it a try, but I'm going to save that to the end to pull a sort of a possible outcome maybe, or where things are headed, or just a final message of the story. I'm going to play around with it. We're just playing here because I have no clue. I just thought this would be fun. And if not, that my niece would use them. So shuffle those up. Let's give these another good shuffle, because obviously there's a lot of cards. I'm just going to do a 9 card and see what comes of it. Again, I have no idea. Okay. So let's... 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Now my intention is, or my thinking is, that these would be read a little bit more linearly, like a story, but I think we also have to figure out what's going on here. So, once upon a time, there's a person who is feeling quite cursed, right? They're feeling as if we have this little, I don't even know what this is. We have like a little owl, but there's like an evilness, looks like it's kind of surrounding him, and he looks quite scared. So once upon a time, there was somebody who was feeling very much cursed and overwhelmed, and as if things just were not going right. They just felt like this air around them, just things were not right. When we look to the corner, we can see that these are somebody who it feels as if they have so many obstacles to get around. They have so much that they have to surmount that it feels insurmountable. And they feel like a beggar instead of like a king. They don't feel, they are not owning their who they are and being a king unto their castle, because they are feeling beggared, and this beggarness is kind of drawing down the crown that we see. However, we can see that there is a stream and a river. If we go this way, we can see that there is a mountain, and if we can just get over it, there's going to be green pastures and river that's going, and it's taking them to a great treasure. So we can see that that's going on. We have a treasure that is quite interesting, because it's almost going backwards. We have a journey that's taking them down the road to wealth and things working out very well, but it's going backwards for some reason. We have to understand that there is a treasure to be found. That's what's going to get us out on the road and taking this journey towards things becoming better than what they are. We also have that when we do own our who we are and own our sense of royalty that we have, that is going to take us to the palace. But then it doesn't end there, and we start the journey all over again. Right now, the journey is feeling stopped. So that's quite interesting there. When we look across here to this person who's feeling quite cursed, we again have that sense of movement. And what is the movement going towards? The movement's going towards the palace. It's going towards that sense of place, that sense of home, that sense of good things to come. And all will be well, and all will be well. But it's, you know, it's definitely difficult right now. There's definitely some obstacles to overcome. And so then if we turn around and we pull a happily ever after card just to see a possible outcome, I wouldn't even say possible outcome. I don't really like possible outcome. But where are things, if nothing changes, maybe? No. Just a general message, maybe. Let's see what we get. So the queen gave them the prize he had promised. So this is an acquisition kind of energy. This is an energy of getting what was promised, getting, in a sense, what maybe even was deserved. But it takes the work of getting through the obstacles, and that is going to lead you to a place in which you do get the things that you deserve. It's next to the palace as well. So again, we have that sense of life. There's that sense of reward, that there is a sense in which life rewards hard work. It doesn't mean that you're going to have literal piling up with treasures, but this is more just reward in general. And sometimes the actual journey, the actual struggle, the actual path over the mountain, sometimes that is the reward in and of itself. But we have, there we go, that is an example of how you might read these particular cards. Okay, so let's pull these up. That's a Happily Ever After card. So let's think about an actual question. Of course, that's a general thing. So let's have a question that somebody might ask. So let's just say somebody has asked a work-related question. They're thinking about changing jobs, trying to figure out the pros and cons, or they're just trying to figure out whether or not they need to change their job. So we're just going to look at things to do with work surrounding a person. Of course, I don't really like fake questions. You know how I am, but I don't have any questions at the moment that aren't somebody's personal questions. But we're just playing here. So we're going to lay one, two. I just felt like nine is just going to be the right. So we have a parent, the prince, and the door. So that's quite interesting because we can think about, you know, the responsible thing, being responsible. Ooh, we have an enemy here in the middle. Time is passing. Escapes. Time is passing and into town. So it may be... escape is coming from this job, but it may take a little bit of time, and it may actually take a separate move, which is quite interesting there. We do have the enemy, which shows that, you know, if just in terms of overall energy, that would say to me that, you know, maybe the job that they're in isn't the best thing. There may be something that is going to block them from being able to shift out of this job, and so we want to pay attention to that as well. We do have the parent here in the corner. There is that sense of being responsible, that this isn't something that you should make a decision lightly, but that you do need to be responsible. You may need to look for advice from people that you respect, but in the end, this is on the person themselves to make this decision, that they're going to have to weigh the information. They may get an advice, but this is on this person's themselves to make a decision about this and decide whether they're going to step through the door or not. We do have a sense of things that are sleeping. So there may be, again, that sense right now, just kind of sleepwalking through life in this current job. It may not be the best place for them because they may just feel as if they are sleepwalking through life. But we have the wolf howling at the moon on the other side. So that is that sort of call to wake up, so to speak. And then, like I said already, I kind of saw that before. We do have a sense of escape. So that is the idea of maybe it's time to leave. You got to wait for the timing to be right. You got to make sure that you're getting advice, and you need to be ready to move. Now, that may be literally moving, or maybe that sense of you need to be ready to move when the time is right, kind of like the Eight of Swords, be ready, because you might have to snag an opportunity as it comes. So you have that going on there. So then if we pull kind of a, let's just pull an ending card. Let's just call it that. I don't really like Happily Ever After because they're not all happily ever after. But we'll just say let's pull an ending card and see what we get. So they promise never to fight again, which is interesting because we have the enemy card in the middle. So that would tell me that perhaps this, again, sort of reinforces the idea that it's time to A, act like adults if there is actual squabbling that's going on in the worst-case scenario, or there is that sense of needing to get yourself out of the situation in which you're feeling combative. And so if this job is one that you are actually kind of feeling embattled, then it's time to move on and time to get yourself in a position where you're not going to be fighting. So kind of stuff just makes me so happy. So I just think it's hilarious. I quite like it. I think I could read really well with these, and I have been wanting to do sort of a story. I have been wanting to put on my Etsy shop an actual story reading where, you know, I'm doing an actual reading for an actual question, but I'm going to write it in story format. And so I've really been wanting to do that since I started the shop. And so when I saw these cards, I thought, oh, this is absolutely perfect. I think this is going to work for that particular reading. So I'm going to do some tester ones and write up some tester stories. But I think that this is going to work really well. And so my intention is... But again, what I was just doing for you is reading, but what I will do is actually kind of tell a story, kind of like a fable story, and then go about reading it in the way in which that I told you. So I know people do that with tarot cards and things like that, but it's something I do all the time. I did it all the time when I was learning to read tarot. And so, of course, as my thing is truth and story, I need a story time reading for my shop. And I think these cards are the ticket. So if you are interested in being a test case for getting a story reading, put a comment in the description box. Make sure you're subscribed, obviously, but put a comment in the description box, and I will pull. I don't know how many I can do, but over the next, it probably will take this next week because I have some things that I have to get done and caught up on readings. But within the next week or so, I'm going to do a few of these stories. So if you're interested in going into a drawing to get one of these, email me at thetruthandstory@gmail.com and put once upon a time reading in the subject line. And then put, you know, if you have a specific question or at least an area that you're interested in, you know, just give me whatever information as if you were going to get a reading. Go ahead and give me that, and then I will, you know, draw some names and do that. I will probably do a couple video ones and a couple written out ones just in terms of testing things out. Again, it probably will not be within the next couple days. I have to get readings caught up, but it will be, you'll get it back within the next week or so. So there we have it. Thanks for taking a peek with me at this. It's just, I think this is going to be a lot of fun. So